फ्रेंड्स, आपका स्वागत है हमारे चैनल पर। आज हम आपके लिए लेकर आए शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस, क्वेश्चन प्लस आंसर, माइक्रोवेव इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट से रिलेटेड है। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन है आपका, व्हाट इज माइक्रोवेव इंजीनियरिंग? माइक्रोवेव इंजीनियरिंग इज द स्टडी एंड डिजाइन ऑफ माइक्रोवेव सर्किट्स, कंपोनेंट्स एंड सिस्टम। फंडामेंटल प्रिंसिपल ऑफ अप्लाई टू एनालिसिस, डिजाइन एंड मेजरमेंट टेक्निक्स इन दिस फील्ड। द शॉर्ट वेवलेंथ इन्वॉल्व distinct guys this discipline from electronics engineering. So this is because there are different interaction with the circuits, transmission and propagation characteristics at microwave frequency. Now next question is, define microwave. So microwave are generally described as electromagnetic waves with frequencies that ranges from approximately 1 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. Therefore microwave signals, because of their inherently high frequencies, at relatively short wavelength, hence the name microwave. Now, next question, write the applications of microwave engineering. So, following are applications of microwave engineering are available. First one is the antenna gain is proportional to the electrical size of the antenna. At higher frequency, more antenna's gain is therefore possible for a given physical antenna size, so which has important consequences for implementing miniaturized microwave system. Now, next one is, more bandwidth can be realized at higher frequencies. Bandwidth critically important because available frequencies band in the electromagnetic spectrum are being rapidly depleted. Okay. Now next is application of the microwave is signal travels by the line of sight or not bent by the ionosphere as or lower frequencies signals and thus satellite and terrestrial communication link with very high capacitors are possible. Now, define a microwave junction T. So the interaction, the point of interconnection of two or more microwave devices is called microwave junction. Okay. Define a scattering matrix. So in a microwave junction, there is interaction of three or more components. There will be an output port. So in addition, there may be reflection from the junction of other ports. Totally, there may be many combinations. These are represented easily using a matrix called S matrix. Okay. Now, what are the properties of the matrix? There are three properties of the matrix given a S matrix. Next question, write the unitary property for a lossless junction. For any lossless network, the sum of the product of each term of any one row or of any column of this S matrix multiplied by its complex conjugate is unity. Next question. Now, define T-junction. So, in microwave circuit, a waveguide or coaxial line with three independent ports is commonly referred to as a T-junction. Now, what is E-plane T? So, an E-plane T is a waveguide T in which the axis of its side arm is parallel to the E-field of the main guide. What is H-plane T? So, an H-plane T is a waveguide T in which the axis of its side arm is shunting the E-fields are parallel to the edge field of the main guide. Now, define difference of, so according to the E-plane and S-plane, in E-plane T, the parallel cutoff, parallel out of port 3 is proportional to the difference between the instantaneous powers entering from port 1 and port 2. Therefore, this third port is called as difference of, and according to S-plane T, if two input waves are fed into port 1 and port 2 of the collinear arms, so the output waves at port 3 will be in phase and additivity. Okay. So because of this, this third port is called as sum of. Now, what do you mean by hybrid junction? So a hybrid junction is a four-port network in which a single incidence on any one of the ports divides between two output ports, with the remaining port being isolated. And it is also called the magic T. Now, why bends are used? So bends are used to alter the direction of propagation in a waveguide system. What is a hybrid ring? So hybrid ring consists of an annual line of proper electrical length to sustain standing waves, to which four arms are connected at the proper intervals by means of series or parallel junction. Now, define isolator. So an isolator is a two-port non-reciprocal device which produces a minimum attenuation to wave in one direction and very high attenuation in the opposite direction. 15th question, why isolator are called uniline? an ideal isolator completely absorbs the power for propagation in one direction and provides lossless transmission in the opposite direction. Thus, isolators are called uniline. Now, give the application of directional coupler. So, unidirectional power measurement, SWR measurement, unidirectional wave launching, deflectometer, balanced duplexer. Now, next question. Give a note on directional coupler. So, directional coupler are transmission line devices that couple together two circuits in a one direction while providing a great degree of isolation in the opposite direction. Now, next question, what are the different types of directional couplers? So, we have three types of directional coupler: two-hole directional coupler, bi-hole directional coupler, four-hole directional coupler. Next question is, define coupling factor. So, the coupling factor of a directional coupler is defined as the ratio of the incidence power to the forward power factor measured in dB, not power factor, output power. Okay, define directivity of directional coupler. So the directivity of a directional coupler is defined as the ratio of the forward power is PF to the backward power PV measured in the dB. So yahan par bhi PF aapka kya hai, forward power represent kar raha hai. What is the Faraday's rotation law? So if a circularly polarized wave is made to pass through a ferrite rod which has been influenced by an axial magnetic field B, then the axis of polarization gets tilts in clockwise direction, and amount of tilts depends upon the strength of magnetic field and geometry of the ferrite. List two microwave devices using Faraday rotation principle. So isolator and circulator. Now give some coupling parameters of the directional coupler. So coupling coefficient, directivity, insertion loss, isolation. So what are the ferrite and give its properties? So ferrite are ceramic like material. These are made by sintering a mixture of metallic oxide. Now, properties, specific resistivities may be used as much as 1014 greater than that of metals, and dielectric constants around 10 to 15 or greater than. Okay, and third is relative permittivity is 1000. Now give some examples of the ferrite devices like isolator, circulator, phase shifter, modulator, power limiters are the ferrite devices. Now, what are the advantages of the ABCD matrix? So, they are used in power transmission line. They are helpful in the case of the cascade network. Now, what are the junctions? So, give some examples. A microwave circuit consists of several microwave devices connected in some way to achieve the desired transmission of microwave signal. The interconnection of two or more microwave may be regarded as microwave junction. Now, just like T, hybrid ring. So, these are the some example of the junction. So, what are the non-reciprocal devices? Give two examples. So, the device which are the having properties that the forward characteristics are not equal to the reverse characteristics are called non-reciprocal devices. Okay. So, यहाँ पर आपका examples नहीं दिया. Next part जो हमारे यहाँ पर हम release करेंगे part two में, वहाँ पर हम non-reciprocal devices के पहले examples आपको show करेंगे. Then उसके बाद जो और भी questions हैं, short questions वगैरह हैं, वो हम आपके सामने present करने वाले हैं. तो कंटिन्यू वॉचिंग करने के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका, और इस कोरोना के टाइम पर आप लोग अपना और अपने फैमिली को बहुत ख्याल रखिए. जय हिंद.